Hello everyone, welcome to Super Duper Kitchen. So today we are going to see the recipe for Unniyappam or Neyyappam. So it is a small round sweet that is made with rice flour, jaggery, cardamom powder, coconut bits, and some people also use sesame seeds. So now let's see how to make this traditional Kerala delicacy. So first take a cup of raw rice into a bowl and add water and wash it well to remove dust particles, and then drain the water. Now add fresh water and soak the rice for 1.5 hours. So after 1.5 hours, we are just going to drain this water, throw this water off, and we are going to spread this rice on a kitchen towel, or you can also use white dhoti to spread this rice. So dhoti is the better option because it absorbs the moisture content in the rice easily. So now if you see, there is some dampness, but there is no water molecules on the rice. So at this time you can just transfer it into a mixie jar and you can make it into a fine powder. So now we are going to grind it to a fine powder and we are going to sieve it to get a really fine powder. So then we have to repeat the steps couple of times or even 4 times until we get the fine powder. So now we are going to add this coarse particles into the mixie jar and we are going to repeat the same step, like we are going to grind it into a fine powder, then again we will be sieving this powder. So until you get just a tablespoon of rice particle on the sieve, you are going to repeat this process. So now the rice flour is ready. So now take 1.25 cups of jaggery, add 1/4 cup of water and dissolve the jaggery. So there is no need to make any string consistency, it's just enough to dissolve the jaggery. Also, after dissolving the jaggery, we are going to cool it down. Only then we are going to mix it with the rice flour. Do not add the rice flour when it is hot. So apart from the rice flour and jaggery, here I have taken cardamom powder, 2 tablespoons of thinly sliced coconut bits, and I have mashed half banana, ripened banana. So now the next step is to mix everything together. So for this, first strain the jaggery syrup, and then you can see the dirt particles. Now you can add the mashed banana. So make sure you add the right quantity of banana, and then thinly sliced coconut bits, cardamom powder, and mix well. So if you add more banana, then the batter will become very soft and it will be very difficult to make up, and you cannot turn it, flip it and cook. So it will become very soft, so be careful. So finally add the rice flour and make the batter. Do not form any lumps while making the batter. It should be a smooth batter, and the consistency is, it should be slightly thicker than the dosa batter consistency. So traditionally it is made in a bronze karal, so it can also be called as evil whisker pan. So here I'm going to use this non-stick pan and add a 1/2 teaspoon of ghee. Then we are also going to add some oil into each this hole, because if we cook only with the ghee, then the neyyappam will become hardened. So we are also going to use oil. So now heat the oil, and once the oil is reach the right temperature, we are going to add the batter into each hole. So while cooking the neyyappam, we are going to keep it in medium flame. So if we keep it in the high flame, then what happens is, like, it will not be cooked properly. It will turn brown or black easily, but the appam is not cooked properly. So always keep it in medium flame while cooking the neyyappam. So now we are adding the batter. So there is no need to use any baking soda or maida for making this appam. So I have seen many people using those. So now if you see that appam is getting cooked, so at this stage, just when the little amount of batter is left uncooked, so just flip it so that what happens, the uncooked batter will again get poured into the hole and it will form a cup. So that's how you get that neyyappam shape, a ball like a structure. So if we cook it, make it in a bronze vessel, then really we will get some big appams, but in non-stick we get small appams, but the texture is very right, and So now it is almost done. So you can remove it from the pan and you can allow it to cool it down. Then you can store it in an airtight container. If the neyyappam is cooked well, then it will stay for 3 to 4 days. So superb neyyappam is ready. So do try this recipe at home and give me your feedback. See you all in another recipe. Until then, it's bye from Niranjana Shankar Narayanan. Thank you.